Sports for sports and gaming is the exquisite fusion. We are leaving January, heading into my birthday month and a lot of others, February. But right now, we're going to stay right in this moment here. So I hope that you got your essentials to lock it in. Thank goodness. It is Friday. Thankful, glorious, inspirational, fulfilling, satisfying, and stillness. Thank goodness it's Friday. And we all made it. So that's what makes it extra special. All right. Before we get started, I want to send love to my one and only KBG Glover and to the Glover family in Chucktown, Charleston, a little city beside the sea, a place where my roots are deeply rooted. He was the musical director, editor of 1021 Magazine, which is celebrating 20 years for 2022. And on this date, he got his angel wings. This date right here. So I send love, and I also receive love. That's something that either some people believe in or some people do not, which is perfectly fine with me. I'm not here to persuade anyone to have the beliefs, but I was showing some love practically like for a couple of days now coming through, because I am a believer that love does not die and that the spirit moves on from the physical realms, and you are to live on, but you can still feel your loved ones. So I've been definitely getting an array of different feelings, and so missed, and just wanted to show love, that you are loved forever. And it is only farewell until many of us get to the other side. All right. So, it's been a whirlwind of sports, so we're just going to keep this real chilled. If you would like, if you are a cigar aficionado, you can head on over to Cigar St. Sister, where I'm publisher and founder. And over there, I'm going to be having a cigar and chilling. And I'm also going to be having some stuffed clams. are so good. Okay? It's always good when you can get the humongous stuffed crabs and stuff them yourself. That way you can have more of the meaty texture of the clams. So I thought that would be good with a nice cold beer and a nice cigar. So make sure you head on over, because I'll be going there to light up a stogie. And I also want to send a birthday love to my cousin.
The true measure of character is when one handles power.
So bad about birthdays. But my cousin just celebrated a birthday. Some friends just celebrated a birthday that I have been friends with since like kindergarten. And it's just so many people. So I send birthday love to them. And I also send birthday love to everybody for January. And birthday love for everybody coming up in February as well. My grandmother, February the 1st, and my good girlfriend, Cammy, both share the birthday of February the 1st. And this is a special time, so I'm not quite sure what we're going to do for my grand-mère, because this will be her 100th birthday. So, there's that. Alright, so, let's talk about football here as we go into the 7 minutes of chill. And let's just really open up the airwaves here. Not quite what we were expecting, many of us, but refreshing to see not the same teams go back to the championship games, but to see new teams. And for a fact, because I like doing the fact vibration, Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, within a decade, 2 years, 12 years, they are not NOT, NAWT, they are not in the conference title games. Close. But not close enough. And again, I think that it's very refreshing that we don't see them. Just brings about something new, a change, refreshing, the old guard moving away. Okay? New life, new vibes, new moments. So, get ready with your tailgating. Still don't know what I'm going to prepare, but it'll be something good. Championship Sunday, there will be no games on Saturday, starting January the 30th, 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on CBS. The Bengals and the Kansas City Chiefs face off. Then at 6:30 p.m. on Fox, San Francisco and the LA Rams, 49ers and the Rams, Cincinnati Bengals, Kansas City Chiefs. So, I've been doing a lot of talking with good friends and family, and some people are like, I don't care one way or the other. And then you have others, and their team is not in it, but they do have their say, their picks, and I love that. Now, that's what I love about sport fans, and then you have sport fans. The sport fans who, like, I don't care. Got a lot of those. I was like, well, I won't ask you again. And then they hit me back with the LOL, but you can keep your LOL because you didn't mean it. Like, LOL, you just was being snappy, so keep your little snappiness. I'm matching energy from time to time. A lot of people are saying that they like Kansas City. They're seeing Kansas City getting this second title since they couldn't get it back to back. Others are saying the Bengals is going to come through. Now, that would be pretty cool. Of course, I was telling people, not going in depth, but like telling people, my cousin Joe Mixon plays for the Bengals. But I'm not lying about that. It's just that we have to get together to pinpoint how it comes to meet up. That name is not common at all. But it's a lot of us, okay? And the roots stem in the low country. That is a fact. But the initial roots is from England because of from what I could see, how the Mixon name came into being. And of course, my grandfather on the maternal side, he had did it back in the day when a lot of people were doing the genealogy for when Roots came out. So he has this big book. But with more technology, it starts to break down the family tree. So from what I gather, it's going to be the Low Country. But it started in England because my, let me count it down. My sixth generation grandfather is Caucasian, an Englander. And so from there, like I said, on my maternal side and my grandfather, it was just so easy to trace it because of the name and everything. So we have a lot of family, of course, on the East Coast, South, in the North, Midwest, and West Coast, because from what I can see from my records, and I'm such a sleuth investigator, people left the Great Migration. So we got a lot of the Mixons in Milwaukee, Ohio, Chicago, New York, Philly, D.C., and California. And so they're just everywhere. And again, it's just, it's not a name that out of the sky. And of course, he does have the looks. So, getting back on the subject here, the Bengals could pull it out all the way. That would be great for the Bengals. Absolutely. San Francisco 49ers. You can't count them out, even though a lot of people are saying LA is going to pull up. But you never know. I mean, with the additions that happened with the Los Angeles Rams, they really did pull up in getting good talent, setting up the building blocks to get where they are now. Still cannot count out the Chiefs, and the Bills can tell you that, and not just the Bills that got burnt and served their daggers, but other teams, even before they became the Super Bowl champions with Mahomes. Andy Reid and company, the way that they set up the playbook, the way that they set up the plays, the way that they try to go ahead and finish them, the daggers. You gotta play them to the end. Because then it'll be like, what just happened? That's exactly how they get down. And then now some people were saying, change the overtime rules. We do not need an overtime rule that says, play a first quarter and then see who wins. if you can't get it done or show some really good tenacity with each other to go into an overtime, if you can't get it done in four quarters, then yes, toss the coin. Whoever makes that titty, call it a wrap. You just got served the daggers. Like, who was the... So, if I would do all this extra first quarter, then are you going to pay me, like, quarter time? Like, triple time, quarter time? I mean, you know. So, I think the rules are fine with overtime as it is. What we saw in the original games was the Bills 36 and Kansas City 42. Okay, just like that. Just like that. And then the LA Rams 30 and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers 27. Do I think this is Tom Brady's final swan song? No, I do not. I think that he'll play another year and just see how it goes. Okay? I love the moment of how there's so much unpredictable vibrations. I love that for many reasons. I think it makes for excitement back into the league that now we have these teams and young quarterbacks and young players mixed in with veterans, and you know, we're seeing a different vibe. So I'm excited. I really don't know how to call it, but at first I said what would be good for this matchup of going to the Super Bowl would be the Kansas City Chiefs and the LA Rams. That was my first pick. And then I said what would be good if it was the Bengals and the LA Rams. I guess some people are like, why are you hating on the 49ers? I'm not, because they could get there. But I think that would be a really good match. Either Bengals and the LA Rams or Kansas City and the LA Rams. I think that would be great. So we'll see. We'll see if I get obliterated or if I do not get obliterated. Of course, we know AB is making his rounds again in Sportsland, and he put up on his social media the Bucks eliminated Pitt, not the Palace, and the picture where he was holding up his hands, shirtless, going off the field during the New York Jets game. And you know, now he's talking about wanting to play with Lamar Jackson. You know, not really sure if that's going to come into fruition. But also, like I said before, AB, what did AB do? Still not a former NFL player. With all this controversy that's happening, I mean, it is what it is. Antonio Brown says the Bucks offered him $200,000. Dollars to get mental health treatment. So then he goes face to face with Brian Gumbel, of course, with the lawyers right there. And Brian Gumbel was like, do you think you need mental help of any kind? Okay. And AB said, I have mental wealth. Okay. So we just have to see what happens, doing a lot more interviews with other people, and he's still sticking to his verbiage of the accounts that happened. So, you know, there it is. Another moment that has everybody in an uproar is over in the Hall of Fame vibrations. And that's going to be shut out of the ballot was Barry Bonds. Well, we all know that there's been controversy with Barry Bonds, but there also has been controversy with others as well. So he deserves to be in this moment. But of course, the balloting and the picks is what makes also good sports and good things for people to talk about, like myself in sports media, sports talk, and doing your POVs. Hopefully next year it can happen. But yeah, he should have been there. I felt strongly for this time around as well. But he should have been there. So that's all I got in Sportsland. We got a lot of winter sports that's going to be happening, which is really, really cool. I love watching winter sports. And of course, with tennis happening, and you got hockey, and of course, upcoming soon, as it gets really warmer, we're going to start getting more in depth with these horse racing, because of course you got the crowns sitting there and other great horse races. And so myself, as a horse rider, horse lover, I love equestrian races and all of that. So that's it for me on this take. We're gonna have a lot more takes coming up through the weekend, so make sure you stay locked right here with me, BB Davis, at BB Love Sports, where sports and gaming is exquisite fusion. I'm gonna see about throwing on a nice little groove here before I'm out. But I thank you so much for locking in. I also want to thank 1021 Media Group for holding it down and posting for me, because I have been behind the scenes. If I'm not filming, then I'm doing a lot of other stuff behind the scenes. And of course, having a professional life is good, but also having a private, thriving life is good. And that's what's good for me. Now, I do have some quotes that I want to leave you with. I think that'd be cool, because guess what? Caring is sharing, and it's always good to get some beautiful quotes here. You can feel when your life is about to shift. And I love that. And let me give the full quote of that. Let it and trust that it's going in a better direction. And I love that. Okay, let's say that again. You can feel when your life is about to shift. Let it and trust that it's going in a better direction. And I love this by Sadhguru, okay? Stillness is the core of existence. May you know the very core of who you are. Okay? And I've always been taught that. Be still and know. Be still and know. You know, I do a lot of meditation. And also, to that own self, be true. Okay? So, I'm out of here. Thanks so much for locking in, and stay locked in for more BB Love Sports. The sports that gave me is exquisite fusion. Peace and love, everybody.